Happy Monday, everyone. Good morning. Welcome to San Antonio Living. It's the start of a new year, and in 2022, people are starting new jobs, and sometimes it can feel like the first day of school all over again, but we're not kids. But I still got tips for you on how you can rock that new job, look confident, and feel comfortable, and they're coming from our good friend Diane Gottsman. She's joining us this morning. Hi, Diane. Good to see you.
Nice to see you, Rebecca.
Happy Monday. Now, you know, we just did an interview last week about how Texans are really leading the workplace in starting new jobs, whether they're doing it from home or starting their own business. Either way, starting a new job can be a little nerve-wracking. It can be a little uncomfortable, but you've got some tips for us this morning. So let's start off with first day of work jitters. How do we conquer stuff like that, Diane?
You know, it's that feeling in your stomach, much like kids have, you know, when they go to school on the first day. And the bottom line is that we have to sharpen our social skills, which means that we have to be able to introduce ourselves, feel confident saying our name, smiling, using all of these skills that we're teaching our children. 85% of our job success is based on our ability to put others at ease. So just remember that walking in that front door.
Yeah. And let's talk about something that is on people's minds also, starting a new job. Maybe you're budgeting for the new year. Maybe that could be one of your New Year's resolutions. A good way to budget is to pack your own lunch. Talk to us about, give us some little tips about how we can do that to maybe save time and money when it comes to starting a new job and taking on something new.
Well, I'm saying pack your lunch because I don't want you to expect everyone just to invite you out to lunch lunch on that first day or that first week. You know, we assume people are going to invite us, but it's awkward for them and it's awkward for you. But if you eat lunch at your desk, you're isolating yourself.
Yeah.
You're alone. So if you pack your lunch, eat in the lunchroom, that gives you an opportunity so you can meet people that are on the other side of the office. This is just a great way to network.
Yeah, I had a feeling that's what you meant when you said pack your own lunch, because you never know, that first week can get a little hectic. Now, when you start
that's
a new
right.
job, along comes with it is a lot of paperwork. So a tip for you is to have all your documents ready to go when you're taking on this new job, just to make it easier, right?
So show up prepared. You know, part of showing up to the office, period, is dressing the part, dress one level above what you feel like you would do on a regular basis, just so you're prepared. That also goes with what you bring in your purse or your portfolio. So of course you're going to have your driver's license. You want to have a copy of your license plate if you're going to get a parking pass, social security number, depending on your job, maybe a birth certificate, a passport. So when they ask you, you can already be ready, and you just go to your envelope, take everything out rather than scrambling and looking nervous.
Yeah, that makes sense too. And with a new job often comes new training. You're learning so many new things. It can come at you really, really fast. So it's really important to really use your listening skills, especially during this first week or even month of a new job, right?
That's right. So I say use your listening skills, which means that once you hear what people have to say, you can respond and react, because you have to engage. But in order to engage appropriately, you have to hear, you have to listen to what they're saying. So feel free to jump in and be part of the conversation. However, not too much information. So when you're socializing with your new peers, you don't want to share too much, meaning be cautious. So you're not talking about your past company. You're not trashing your boss. You're not talking about things that you probably shouldn't be talking about until you get the lay of the land and know who you can be comfortable with and who you're not comfortable with.
Great advice, because that really comes with time. And then something else you want to let everyone out there know is that it's okay to ask for help, right? You're going into something new. You might have a lot of questions, but that's okay to stop and ask for help, right?
We fear that if we ask for help, we look incompetent. It's just the opposite. When you're asking for help and asking your coworkers for advice, it shows that you're really interested in learning. Rather than coming in bulldozing and saying, this is how we did it before, this is what I think we should do. First, get to know the corporate culture, get to know how they do things. And then when you want to offer some advice and even some opportunities to make things better, you can do that.
Yeah, and then the best thing to do right now is to really be patient with yourself and with your new workplace and just give it some time, right?
That's right. You are not going to feel completely comfortable for 3 to 9 months. You know, it's much like dating. It's much like getting to know friends. You don't really get to know your surroundings and people around you until you start to interact with them. So again, be cautious, be engaged, be authentically you, and give it some time. It's all going to work out, and just put your best self out there.
Those are really great tips, Diane. Thanks again for joining us this week and for helping everyone out there get started at a new job in the new year. And of course, if you want to connect with Diane, she's Protocol School of Texas. All you got to do is visit her website. She's got lots of great information on there. It's DianeGottsman.com.